I never lie outright, but I've come to see that truth and school teaching are at bottom incompatible, just as Socrates said they were thousands of years ago. The lesson of numbered classes is that everyone has a proper place in the Egyptian pyramid, and that there is no way out of your class except by number magic. Unless that happens, you must stay where you were put. The third lesson I teach is indifference. I teach children not to care about anything too much, even though they should make it appear that they do. How I do this is very subtle. I do it by demanding they become totally involved in my lessons, jumping up and down in their seats with anticipation, competing vigorously with each other for my favor. It's heartwarming when they do that. It impresses everyone, even me. When I'm at my best, I plan lessons very carefully in order to produce this show of enthusiasm. But when the bell rings, I insist everyone drop whatever it is we have been doing and proceed quickly to the next workstation. They must turn on and off like light switches. Nothing important is ever finished in my class, nor in any class I know of. Students never have a complete experience except on the installment plan. Indeed, the lesson of bells is that no work is worth finishing. So why care too deeply about anything? Years of bells will condition all but the very strongest to a world that can no longer offer much important work to do. Bells are the secret logic of school time. Their argument is inexorable. Bells destroy the past and future, converting every interval into a sameness, as an abstract map makes every living mountain and river look the same, though your own eyes and ears and feelings tell you that no two mountains or two rivers are the same. Bells inoculate each undertaking with indifference. The fourth lesson I teach is emotional dependency. By stars and red checks, smiles and frowns, prizes, honors, and disgraces, I teach you to surrender your will, that's a good omen, to the predestinated chain of command. Rights may be granted or withheld by any authority without appeal, because rights do not exist inside a school, especially the right of free speech, which the Supreme Court very recently ruled does not exist inside schools unless school authorities say it does. As a school teacher, I intervene in many personal decisions, issuing a pass for those I deem legitimate or initiating a disciplinary confrontation for behavior that threatens my control. Individuality is constantly trying to assert itself among children and teenagers, so my judgments come thick and fast. Individuality is a contradiction of class theory, a curse to all systems of classification.